Hey YouTube, Cyclone DC here, welcome to another video. You know, the Arab Spring that we've all been sold by our gutless and spineless politicians and clueless media really don't know what they've been selling or cooking. And what I mean is that the politicians and the media really don't understand what the Arab Spring really is. True that the dictators of the Middle East were sponsored in part by the West and America. You know, it's surprising that they're selling to us now that it's an era to remove these brutal dictators and establish new flourishing democracies. But the reality is that they're trying to elevate a hope into reality, to hope that somehow the people of the Middle East will actually understand democracy and what the responsibilities are under democracy overnight. It's never going to happen. It's like trying to wish somehow, some way, that the People's Democratic Republic of North Korea, or Korea I should say, will somehow elect its president for the very first time. Not going to happen. The problem with our gutless and spineless politicians and media is that they have no clue whatsoever about Middle Eastern politics and what it entails. They don't understand that probably 80% of Middle Eastern politics involves religion. But again, you know, they're clueless and they'll report what they're fed without even understanding the implications. The very hard-fought freedoms that the Egyptians fought for basically will be eradicated. The Muslim Brotherhood, the Islamic extremists, have made it very clear, kiss women's rights goodbye, kiss liberalism goodbye, kiss any form of progressive ideology goodbye, because guess what's coming their way? Sharia law, courtesy of the Islamists and the religion of peace. Don't believe me? Just ask Sheikh Karadawi of Egypt and what he has to say about the matter. You know, pretty soon the Middle East will be filled with Islamist regimes that want no dialogue, they want no transition, they just want power. You know, Assad of Syria is basically the glue that keeps the Islamists, or I should say wall, that keeps the Islamists from power. Who do you think is going to take power once he's gone? The Islamists. And if you thought the Middle East right now is volatile, wait until all those Islamists in those Middle Eastern countries take power. Remember, we're having a hard time dealing with Iran, just one Iran. Just imagine 6 or 8 or 10 Irans vying for a nuclear bomb or basically threatening Israel or threatening regional peace. But as usual, our ignorant, gutless, and spineless media and politicians will brush this off as usual and will ignore history. History tells us, like in 1933, that when we allowed Hitler to get, or I should say when the Germans allowed the Nazis to gain power, we all saw how that turned out. Fast forward to September 1939, and we also saw the fruits, if you will, of the Nazis. Six years later, if you will, the Nazis did a bang-up job in Europe, killing basically 6 million Jews, 20 million Russians, millions upon millions of other Europeans, and let alone their own people. But, as usual, history repeats itself, and we do so at our own peril. The Arabs, if you will, do so at their own peril. Peace.